Well, ladies and gentlemen, a little bit of sad news today coming out of my world of reckoning points and miles. We've got a devaluation from United and their Mileage Plus plan to talk about. Like Priority Pass, United just seems to be really good at one thing, disappointment. If this happens to be your first time tuning into my mostly coherent ramblings about loyalty currencies, then welcome. My name's Aaron, and if I can figure out the points and miles a game, you can figure out the points and miles award game. Let's jump right into the numbers. We've got an ACRV of 1.18 cents per United Mileage Plus mile. Unfortunately for fans of Big Blue, this represents a 26% decrease since July when they earned a value of 1.61 cents, though in reality, this could easily be the result of seasonal ticket price variations. In case this is your first time hearing me use the term ACRV, it stands for Average Consumer Redemption Value, a term I made up. Basically, I have a whole basket of hypothetical city pairs for which I research the lowest price available cash prices. These are the numerators. I then divide by the amount of award points a program requires for a mostly similar itinerary on the exact date, less any taxes and fees. I use the low-cost cash approach because I believe the value of a point or mile is only in how effective it can effectively substitute cash. I then further discount this average by 25% to compensate for future devaluation, lack of points earned on award travel, and general hassle involved. A more complete explanation is available for anyone curious, and I'll go ahead and place a link to my valuation method below. Of all the annoying things United does, there's one thing that just drives me crazy. They're close-in booking fees on award travel. For anyone not a Premier Platinum or Premier 1K, it will cost you $75 to book an award flight if that flight departs within 21 days. I think that's just bullshit. With most fees airlines charge, there's at least some, if tiny, amount of labor associated with the additional service. Close-in booking fees charged by United are just straight fleecing of award travelers. It costs them no more to ticket a flight departing in 10 days than it does to ticket one departing next month. United's terrible CEO, Oscar Munoz, has said on multiple occasions he wants to make flying his airline a more pleasant experience. You know, just my opinion, but maybe he could start by not charging customers a fee for doing literally nothing. Now, as is always almost the case with legacy carriers, one's best option for maximizing award redemption values is going to come from international travel. Just looking at straight averages, and we've got 0.93 cents domestically and 2.22 cents on flights leaving the United States. So with this data, we can set up at least a general guideline for those holding Chase's Ultimate Rewards. Sapphire Reserve customers can book travel directly through their portal for 1.5 cents apiece. This would mean that at least in general, it would be a savvy move to book your domestic travel directly through Chase and transfer your points to United for international flights. Of course, there are always exceptions and I tend to look at both options before making any moves. But for those people who just don't want to bother, that's the general recommendation. Getting into specifics, and the absolute best we could do for the month was strangely on an economy ticket between Dallas and London. United was offering it for just 30,000 points plus a stupid $80.60 in taxes and fees. The lowest cost cash alternative was $2,360, likely due to the close-in booking. This gives us an absolutely outstanding redemption value of 7.6 cents per United Mileage Plus mile. By comparison, our worst for the month was 0.37 cents per point. That was on a domestic economy ticket between Atlanta and Kansas City. So, I think these numbers really reinforce what many people already know. United has some great upside and some terrible downside. To further illustrate this, here is the normal distribution of the expected return on Mileage Plus miles. We've got a really good chance of redeeming for 1.63 cents, plus or minus a penny. That's represented in this region here, and an outside shot at something exceeding 4 cents. That's represented in this region of the chart. The final thing I want to get into before calling it a night is a little bit of a credit card plug. The United Mileage Plus Explorer card from Chase. I hold one, and I never use it. except on the occasional paid United Economy flight. Like many co-branded cards, it offers a free checked bag and priority boarding. That's nice, I suppose. It also offers two United Club passes annually. They used to be physical ones, and I would go ahead and just sell those on eBay, but annoyingly, they're now electronic. I guess for those not holding a premium card that offers lounge access and who isn't traveling premium cabin, they're quite nice. However, there is another benefit to this card that's not really advertised all that much, and it's not real well known, but I believe it to be the most valuable perk. And really, it's the only reason I keep the thing. Increased award booking opportunities. Let me show you what I mean. Here is a screenshot of an award ticket search for a flight between LAX and Sydney. In this first example, I'm going in an incognito window, so I'm just searching as a general anonymous person. Right away, we see options aren't that great. We've got one nonstop and then no business class availability except on flights with crap long layovers. Now, let's see what happens when I log in and use my Mileage Plus account tied to my Explorer card and perform the exact same search. Right off the bat, we've got a bunch more availability on reasonable flights. Additionally, business classes open wide up. Not shown in this example, but we often see additional saver level award tickets as well. Honestly, if United and Chase ever discontinued this benefit, I'd cancel the card immediately. At the moment, it costs $95 annually, with that fee being waived the first year. But you also get pre-check with that. I won't spend any time running over the earn rates because, well, it's just not near as good as cards that earn transferable points like the Sapphire Preferred or Amex Gold. And because this really isn't a card review video. So, I think that's about all I had for the night. In summary, recap, we've got an ACRV of 1.18 cents. A best-in-class redemption of 7.6 cents, and a worst-in-class of 0.3 cents. Redemption rates are much better if one is patient and uses their miles for travel that heads outside the United States. And with that, I'll close her on out for the night. If this video has at all been useful, a like, share, or sub is appreciated. If not, go ahead and crush that thumbs down button, and go ahead and see you tomorrow.